we stood here a little over a year ago and talked about the things this will create. And one of the statements I made back then was, we're not even sure everything that's going to be here yet. And as you note around the site, you're starting to see some of that, and more things are coming. So it's a live site. There's live things going on here, new partnerships being created, new developments being created, and it's very exciting. And this is a major component of the $5 billion mile. So the city of Frisco and all our partners are still very excited about it. Clearly, we had a lot of rain this year, and the big question I receive all the time, and I know it's probably on the top of your minds, is, are we still on schedule for the fall 2016 opening? And the answer is yes, we are on schedule. Everyone's working hard. We have over 575 folks out here working at the site, working 7 days a week, and we are on schedule. It will open on time. So that's a very important component of this, and clearly important to the Cowboys, as you'll hear from Stephen Jones. This is the midway point. This is why we're doing this today. You can now have a picture of what's going on out here, the size of it. Charlotte, I think, mentioned to me this is about half the size of the original stadium in Irving, and so it's a fairly major complex, and it'll host a lot of events here. We have 7 cranes still on site and lots going on, but the city of Frisco is very excited about this project. It has created many more offshoots, what I call offshoots, business partners talking to us about locating here. And the city of Frisco is still growing rapidly. We put over 2,200 new homes on the ground last year. You noted a lot of new business announcements, and the best is yet to come is what I leave it at, and the best is yet to come. This is, again, as mentioned, a public-private partnership, and one of our key partners is Frisco ISD. You know, Jerry Jones, when he spoke last year, talked about wanting to create new partnerships with students and kids. And I think you'll hear that from Dr. Lyon. That is really coming to fruition, and many things that they're brainstorming on to create new opportunities for the kids of Frisco and the entire region. This is a regional facility.
Thank you, Mayor Masso. I'll keep my comments very brief. We're one of the fastest growing school districts in the nation. We are expecting to have about 53,000 students next year, and this facility is going to be a real workhorse for our high schools and our athletic programs, our extracurricular marching bands, and that kind of thing. We are very appreciative of the city for all of their cooperation and facilitation of discussions and dialogues regarding what this future holds for our students. Here's an example of the kind of thing that we're talking about that we're really kind of getting excited on. I kind of fretted over who would get the first game in the Star, and why not this? We'll have 8 high schools playing varsity football. How about an all-day celebration extravaganza where we have 8 high school teams in Frisco playing one another on that opening week? And that's the kind of enthusiasm and support and excitement that the Star is generating in our community. I guess I would just close by saying the Cowboys organization have been extraordinary partners. Every conversation, I've said this before, that we have in planning this facility includes a very strong component of what can we do for the benefit of our students, what can we do for kids. And that's why we're involved in this partnership, and it really has been amazing. The goal is to make this partnership the exemplary model of what a private partnership with a city, a school district, and an organization can look like, and we are definitely tracking to accomplish that.
It is an honor to be here, and this is a special time of year. It's an exciting time of year. We're about to kick off training camp, and I know our fans are excited, but nothing like it's been before, mainly because of this project. It's very special to be looking out here and seeing this project and how far we're coming in terms of the advances that we're making. We left Valley Ranch about, I think it was June 21st, right around in there, and we all looked around, Charlotte, Jerry Sr. and myself, and said, you know, this is probably the last time we're ever going to break camp here and be coming back to Valley Ranch. When we do that next year, that'll be the last time we break camp at Valley Ranch, and we'll be coming to our new home here in Frisco. So it's certainly exciting. I look around, I look at this concrete, and I look at these trusses, And it's special, but it reminds me of the strength of our partnership that we have with the City of Frisco and the Frisco Independent School District. As Dr. Lyon and Mayor Massa said, it's been just an unbelievable partnership. It's worked so well, and everybody's worked to make this project the very best it can be. I applaud Mayor Massa and Dr. Lyon for their vision, and I think it's going to pay off in spades. I think of the young Frisco kids that are going to be coming up through the high schools, and it's a unique relationship to have with the Dallas Cowboys. So we're very fortunate to have that. I also think about my son, John Stephen, who's a high school athlete, and he's been very fortunate to be involved in high school sports, but also be involved with the Cowboys. And I can tell you firsthand how it's shaped his life in a positive way, and really gives me goosebumps to think about what's going to happen when these kids rub shoulders out here with the Dallas Cowboys, when they're walking off the field and Tony Romo's walking on. I really think we can make a difference in some of these kids' lives. At the same time, I'm not going to be surprised at all if some of these Frisco kids make a big difference in some of our Cowboy lives as they rub shoulders with these young men and women that are involved here. Again, I'd like to thank the City of Frisco for their partnership. I'd like to thank the citizens of Frisco for their support and what they've done. There's too many people here. I see so many familiar faces to thank, but I do want to recognize Charlotte and Jerry, who are here on behalf of our family today. And again, just how much we appreciate being here. And I look forward to being here full time this time next year. But thank you for being here. What we hope to is when we break camp, as I mentioned, when we break camp out in California, is that we return to our nice offices here in Frisco and start the season right here. That's the goal, and we see no reason why that won't happen. Yes.
Yeah, so the first game, the game that Dr. Lyon talked about, will be either late August, early July, so that time frame. So it's going to be that's the first real event here, and they'll set that date coming up.
Well, as you can see, the first truss is in place, fully installed. We have 11 more to go, so there'll be a total of 12. That'll be happening over the next couple of months.
As you all know from originally, it was a 25-year agreement. It's a $150 million public investment, and you'll get those in the press releases by the City of Frisco and Frisco ISD. And the $90 million of that was for the multi-use event center, and $25 million was for the Cowboys headquarters. And we're using tax incremental finance district funds. So any overruns, anything over that project is the Cowboys' responsibility. And believe me, they are investing, Stephen. I don't know if you want to add to that, but They're not shy about investing in the facility.
Well, I think when Jerry made the statement when we announced this project, he said that he was a good partner. And at the end of the day, he knew that he would spend a lot more than what was budgeted in terms of the commitment. And I can tell you, just the part, the MUEC, the Cowboys office building, and our Cowboys football ops are now well north of $200 million. And you know, we just want this to be special and want it to be right, and we think it is. I think it's going to be the finest high school stadium in the country, and I do think we're going to have the finest professional football facilities in the country as well. Well, I think Jerry and Charlotte in particular can probably get a job about anywhere they want building things. They are experts, and we all have learned quite a bit. But we've got so many great people involved, our team. You know, our construction management team with Mark Hickman and Jeff Stroud and John Dixon in Manhattan, who just does a fabulous job. And Gensler, of course, has done a great job designing all this. So, you know, we're just fortunate to have great people around us, but it has really helped that we've had a background there with AT&T Stadium. But believe it or not, this can, you know, it's every bit the challenge that building that stadium was.
On the high school side, I would contend that the lessons learned at AT&T Stadium have helped here, because we're on the side of the stadium with all of the high school locker rooms and facilities, and it's been really beneficial to understand the needs that we have and the needs of the Cowboys, it's just worked perfectly. So I think that was a lesson for the school district, was how important it is to get the high school aspects of the stadium right, and we have achieved that.
This is part of the bigger picture. Frisco is still one of the fastest growing cities in the country. You have Frisco Station next door, you have the Star Development, you have the Gate, and you have Wade Park. And all of them have extreme activity on them. A lot of corporate relocations, a lot of companies looking to relocate. We just had a major one yesterday we're talking to. I obviously can't share who it is with you. But the interest level is very high, and I think you all see that around you. It's going to continue being high. We call it the $5 billion mile, but I would even go a step further. You know, we're not even including Hall Office Park in that. So it's a lot of activity out here. I can't really give you specifics about companies looking, because those are kind of in the negotiation stage. But you'll see announcement after announcement. The Cowboys this past year announced the Baylor partnership they have, and that's going strong, and they can talk about that a little more. So you'll see more of that. We're talking on many different levels. Besides the retail and the restaurants, the partnership is discussing about fitness. How do we incorporate fitness into this project? The star being the focal point of activities of either 5Ks or marathons or half marathons. There's many angles to not just corporate but also community type events being worked on as we go down the line. And that's the beauty of this project. It's going to continue growing, and we're going to continue adding things to it.